How many plugins can you run on a WordPress website? Stop the video right now and let me know. What is your guess? Can you run 30, 40, 50? What's the maximum amount that you feel safe running before you feel like WordPress is going to just break down or be some giant security vulnerability? Let me know. Don't cheat. Don't watch the rest of the video and then leave a comment. Let me know right now. Has this ever happened to you? Have you ever bought a premium plugin and you go to install it like I'm gonna do right now? Plugin, add new, upload the plugin. And I've got login press here, which lets you customize the look of your login screen. I'm gonna go ahead and install this. All right, and you can see that I've got three plugins active right now and login press is one of them. However, if I go to login press in my sidebar, it wants me to install another plugin to be able to use login press pro because they want the free version and the pro version. So now I've got four plugins installed. That is so annoying because I had three before and now my numbers are starting to get bloated. But it gets worse because on the login press homepage, it says it can limit login attempts and it can do auto login. Well, I want those features. So I go over to login press and I choose add-ons and I see that here's auto login. I'll add that one and then I'll limit login attempts as well. And guess what's gonna happen? You gotta be kidding me. Now I have six active plugins. They're almost all login press. This is ridiculous. Now I'm joking around right now, but I know a lot of people actually feel this way. So I wanna explain to you how plugins actually work so you don't get so upset when you see all of these add-ons. And truth be told, login press is actually genuinely one of my favorite plugins. I use it all the time. I think a good way to explain this problem is to actually show you what a plugin is. So let's build one right now. It's only gonna take a second. Don't worry. I'm on my desktop. I'm just going to add a new folder here. I'm going to call this the custom footer message. All right. So I've got a folder. I've labeled it. Let's go into that folder and I'm going to create a new document. We'll switch this over to plain text, make it a little bit bigger. All right. Now I'm going to write my plugin. All right. I am done coding my plugin. You can see it's called the custom footer message. It is version 1.0 and it's by me, Dave Swift. So let's get this up on the WordPress website. So I'm going to save this. I'll call it custom footer message.php because that's the language we write in for WordPress. All right, now here we go. I've got a folder and inside of that folder is some PHP. So let's zip this up and get it onto WordPress. I'll right click and compress and there it is. I've got a zip file. So I'll go plugins, add new, upload plugin. And here is my custom footer plugin. Upload this and install now. Now, before I activate my plugin that I just coded before you right in front of your own eyes, I'm going to go ahead and show you what the website looks like right now. So here is the footer. It looks very plain and normal looking. All right, it is activated. Now I will reload the front end. And now I've got this custom message here. It says, this is a custom footer message brought to you by the custom footer message plugin. That's amazing, right? Not really, but you get the idea here. That's what a plugin is. It's some code that gets turned on when it's activated within your system. It's extra code. So in the case of login press, let's say I didn't want to use auto login, or maybe I did not want to use social login, but they want to offer that to some people. Well, if they bundle it all together into the primary plugin, then everyone's website has to load that code. And everyone's website becomes vulnerable if there's a security issue. Like for example, with social login, this is connecting up to Facebook and Google. Let's say there is an issue with Facebook and it's a security issue that could affect your website if you have this activated. Now, if you don't want to use social login, you don't have that risk posed to you. It's just not even a possibility because this chunk of the code is not being installed. So by keeping everything more modular, it does tend to bloat up the number of active plugins installed, but it also keeps your website more lean and more secure. So now you know, there's not an exact number of plugins that your system can handle. In fact, what's more important is that you pay attention to how much traffic you're getting to your website and how powerful the plugins are that you're running. I've got a plugin here called Query Monitor running, and it's telling me my system usage. You can see I've got about 20% of the memory being utilized by my existing system. Now there's no traffic to this website, but it's also not a very powerful server. If I turn on WooCommerce, for example, my usage shot up 11% and now I'm at 31% of my memory usage. Now there's more to this than just memory usage. CPU usage is also very important, but we can see at a bird's eye view that activating that one plugin utilized a lot of resources. What if I turn on Learn Dash? Well, now I'm up another 10, 11%. I'm almost at 42%. So just like if you want to play the latest video game and you want to do it at full resolution with high frame rates, you're going to need to have a pretty beefy system. Or if you're editing 8K video, you can't get by with the cheapest Mac Mini. You need one of the Pro, Max, or even Ultra chips. So why don't we understand that when it comes to our website? The more stuff that we're asking our website to do, either running extra software or serving extra visitors, the more powerful of a computer we need in order to do that. And if we don't want to add more power to our computer, we need to understand that it's not going to be able to keep up. So we need to ask the computer to do less. So hopefully that all makes sense to you. But if you're still confused, leave me a comment down below. I'm sorry for tricking you into trying to leave a comment earlier. YouTubers will do anything for engagement, won't we? If you like this video, make sure you click the like button. My name is Dave Swift, and I'll see you in the next one.